It dethroned The Crown to take over the top spot on Netflix last year. And now the juicy romantic drama Virgin River is back for season three, promising even more twist in the story of Mel Monroe, played by Alexandra Breckenridge. Take a look.
You're not listening to what I want.
I know what you want. I don't know if I can give it to you.
I think it would be a tragedy for you to go through your life alone because of a misguided perception of the woman you love.
What do you want me to do, man? You want me to sit around at home waiting for the shooter to turn himself in?
But I made the leap, and now it feels like you're the one trying to protect yourself.
I truly believe that anything worth having is worth fighting for.
Hi, Alex. How you doing?
I'm doing really good. How are you doing?
I'm doing all right. I tell you, when my producer told me that I was going to do this interview, I mean, I was just over the moon because she knows how much I love this show. It was such an escape for me during the pandemic, and I'm glad that it's back for a third season. And people love this show. It is like record-breaking, crazy.
It's bananas.
What was your reaction, Alex, when you first heard about what a huge hit this show had become?
You know, the first season did really well. I was kind of surprised, in all honesty, because when I took the job initially, and you know, we shot the first season about a year before it aired. Ish, maybe 9 months, not, I can't really remember. But at that time, what was popular on Netflix and popular on, you know, other channels was not something so, I don't want to say Hallmark, because I feel like it's a crisscross between Hallmark, Lifetime, and Netflix, because it is a little bit edgier than Hallmark, but it has the feel-good stuff. You know, so it's a little bit more grounded than those networks, if I may be so bold. Anyways, I was shocked that it had done so well, and I was like really proud because I thought you can go through Netflix and you're just like, oh, you know, you preview watch,
and then
it just goes away and you never see or hear from it again. The show,
yeah. And that's what, you know, it just breaks your heart. And yeah, I will say it. It does give you, you know, Lifetime, Hallmark, those feel good romance, small town. But then it is so much edgier. The storylines, you know, that we get out of this. And that's what I love about it. It just, you know, and the character development, I think, is just more deep. It's deeper. Let me just say that.
It is deeper.
It just really is. You really get attached to these characters.
Yeah. Well, that's great.
Yeah. Yeah. You know, I'm like, okay.
Yeah. No, I think, you know, from the beginning, I would always tell Martin on set, I would just say, just roll with it. Nobody's going to watch the show. Which is not a popular thing to say. I understand that. But for me, it was so freeing because I just thought, you know, it was like before it aired and I didn't really know that many people were going to watch it. And so I was just like, I'm just going to pour my heart out onto this show and really take it in and be present and like, just really go for it. And so, well, pleasantly surprised that it's done so well.
Yeah. I mean, but I love that. I love that you guys were like, listen, let's just go for it. What do we have to lose, right? And it paid off really well. So let's talk about the characters and let's start with your character, Mel. You know, for those who are not tuned into this, you know, she moved to this small town, which is so beautiful. And we can talk about that in a minute, to kind of escape her life and start over. And, you know, we've seen this happen now for two seasons. Now we're at season three. What do you love about playing this character?
I love all of the emotional arcs that I get to travel through as an actress. At times it's hard. It's very painful. You know, I have to follow her through the trenches of loss and what that brings up for her and you know, so at times it is very challenging and hard for me to dive back into that. Some actresses are like, oh no, I love that stuff. I'm like, oh, so hard. You have to just reach into your gut and pull it out. And that's something that, you know, normally we don't do in life. We just shove it all down. But, you know, being able to go through those emotional journeys with her has been really a lot of fun. And the romance of it all is so intriguing. And it's, I know people love to watch it and, you know, so I'm just all in. My chips are all in.
Yeah, you all have mastered, Mel and Jacque have mastered the will they, won't they, but in season 3, we know that they will, right? They are a solid couple, but not without challenges. What can you tell us about the romance for your character and Jacque this season?
Well, I think it's pretty obvious, even just from the trailer, that Mel comes back around to wanting to try again, wanting to try to have a baby. It's something that she's wanted her entire life. And she tried really hard for with her husband that just, you know, didn't happen and ended in a lot of tragedy for her. But she's a brave person and she's a hopeful person and she wants to try again. She's fallen in love with this man and she knows that it's a leap. She knows that he's having babies with somebody else and she knows it's a tall order, but she's brave enough to put it out there. And we're just going to have to see how he handles that.
What's it like to play? I mean, because you get to see the scripts obviously before we do, to be a part of this, you know, and on television, it's like, well, when couples get together, that's when it, that's like, you know, the curse of a will they, won't they. When they get together, it never works out.
Right. I mean, well, because it's drama. You know, you have to be kept on your toes. So there's always going to be an obstacle in any romantic relationship, because as much as people want the happy ending and they want people to work out, it's not sustainable always. So there's going to be twists and turns and things that people have to navigate, just like in life.
Yeah. You
know, nothing stays like this.
Nothing is perfect. And I love that. I feel like with all the characters that we see, you all touch on just about every issue someone could have in their life within this show.
Yes, almost. I think, you know, hopefully if we get picked up again, we can branch into some more things that are more prevalent in, you know, in society and culture right now. But yeah, I mean, we touch upon many different aspects of people's emotionality for sure.
Yeah. One of the other relationships that I love that Mel has and that we've seen evolve is with Doc. Mm-hmm. I love where that relationship is. That must be a lot of fun for you to play as well, to have that relationship.
It is. I think the combative nature of their relationship when she first started at the clinic was really fun, as hard as it was to play, because Tim Matheson is such a lovely person.
Yeah.
But he's also such a great actor. So we playing off of each other has always been a joy. And being able to watch him kind of slowly break down over the last couple seasons to where he lets her in this way. And he's just become softer as we've gotten to know him. And I think his current health situation has softened him up even more.
Yeah, it definitely has. And now there's the search for this new doctor that, you know, there's like so many changes possibly coming to Virgin River. But I have to ask you about just one of the things that drew me in, and you were talking about, you know, shooting up in Canada, is just how scenic it is. It is so, like, my sister and I, we watched this show and we're like, okay, we're going to move to a small town. We're just going to... I mean, what's it like? What's it like being there on location when you're there, waking up to that and just immersing yourself in that?
It's stunning. I mean, British Columbia is absolutely beautiful. The locations we get to film in are breathtaking. And so when we are there, it is it's a joy. It's such a joy because, you know, we're in Vancouver. So for the most part, I think a lot of people are staying in Vancouver, like in the city.
Yeah.
Then we get to travel out into these remote areas and work. And so we're working, but it's like a mini vacation day at the same time.
Yeah, I could only imagine. It's so beautiful. Well, fans also know you as Sophie on This Is Us. The finale shocked everybody when Kevin didn't marry Madison.
Oh,
I know. Does this mean there's hope for him and Sophie?
I think there is always hope for Kevin and Sophie. That's how I like to look at it, because I think that they have shared so much of their lives together since they were kids, and they have a kind of love that a lot of people have never experienced. I mean, falling in love with somebody when you're 8 is pretty profound. I don't even know if you really can in that capacity when you're 8 years old.
Yeah.
I think you have to wait until your frontal cortex has actually like fused together at whatever age it is, 25 or 26, before you can really be like, oh yeah, I know who I am and I'm in love with this person. But they grew up together and they know each other through and through. And so my hope is always for them to end up together, even though I think maybe it's a split camp at this point. You know, I think he's having children with Madison. They've been trying to make it work. I think people are invested in that relationship at this point. And I totally get it. Obviously, you want to keep the family together. I get it. Sometimes, you know, sometimes that doesn't work out. And maybe Sophie will come back. I don't know.
Well, we'll see. We would love that. I mean, what are your thoughts on, you know, the final season of this show that really just kind of had a huge impact on the landscape of the way we watch TV and the way television is done? What are your thoughts on it wrapping up?
You know, the writers on This Is Us, they're always, I mean, gosh, some of these episodes are so the intricate in the way that they mold characters and the depths in which that they mold these characters. They really, really think about this, and they take the time to psychologically dissect people's reactions and the way that something that happened to you in the past will affect your future. And that's my favorite part about the show. So I can only imagine that the final season is going to be a beautiful representation of that.
Yeah, well, it'll be good to see Kevin and Sophie back together in the final season. We'll see what happens.
I hope so.
I just am. All right, okay, so finally, a shout out to my hometown. Just like your character, Mel, left LA to move to Virgin River. You left LA to move to Atlanta, which is my hometown. I was just down there. I'm getting ready to go back.
Oh, I didn't know you're from Atlanta.
Yes, yes, yes. How do you like it?
Well, I love it. I mean, I've lived here since I started. Well, I started doing The Walking Dead, and then I moved here kind of about the season that I got eaten. And my husband and I were like, we found this little town and we just thought this is where we want to have children. So yeah, let's be small town people, you know? So it's kind of like Virgin River in a way.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, I feel like it's a great mix of, you know, you get that urban feel if you want to feel like you're in a city, and then you can also have that Virgin River feel depending on where, you know, you end up in the suburbs around Atlanta. So
absolutely.
Many
options. Atlanta, I mean, the city of Atlanta is so awesome. There's so much good food. I was just talking to my girlfriends about going into one of our favorite restaurants, Kimball House.
Mm.
I don't know if you've ever been there. I think it's in Decatur. It's so delicious.
Oh, really? In downtown Decatur? Yeah, I was just there and I was in Midtown. I spent a lot of time in Midtown when I was there. But yeah, downtown Decatur is another. I actually grew up in DeKalb County.
Oh, okay.
So like we say Decatur where it's greater. That's what we all say.
Know that. Now I have like.
Yes, Decatur where it's greater. That's what we say.
I'm going to be super hip now with the people that are actually from Georgia.
You really will be.
Yeah.
And always say, meet me in Decatur where it's greater. You know, yeah. Decatur where it's greater. All right. Well, lastly, I want to talk to you about photography. It's a big part of your life. Do you still have time for that? And do you see yourself getting into directing or, you know, taking that photography to and merging it with your career?
I would love to. I haven't had time for photography. I am a very visual person, just, you know, innately, and have always been, you know, more creative than anything else. So I would love to get into directing at some point. Not tomorrow. I still have some work to do on, you know, understanding that aspect of the work that we do. But yeah, absolutely. Absolutely.
I love hearing that. Fantastic. Yeah. Well, let me let everybody know that season 3 of Virgin River is streaming now on Netflix. So be sure to check it out. Alex, thank you so much.
Thank you so much. It's so awesome to talk to you.